Today we have a showdown between a $1,600 scanning software package and a $10 iPhone app. Which one is better for users with low vision? Let's find out. This is Power On. For people who are blind, reading a paper document without assistance can be difficult, to say the least. This is OpenBook, a program that's designed by Freedom Scientific, an assistive technology company whose CCTV device made an appearance in our last episode. OpenBook is a program that converts documents into digital text using optical character recognition, or OCR for short. The program is designed only for Windows computers and comes with a desktop camera that plugs into your computer and enables you to load these digital documents on your computer via OpenBook software or other word processing programs like Microsoft Word. For books and magazines, OpenBook can take consecutive pictures of each individual page, allowing you to scan an entire book in record time. This is Prizmo, an app that's available in the iPhone App Store for just about $9.99. It shares a lot of features with OpenBook, like image capturing, OCR, and text diction, but at less than 1% of the cost of OpenBook, can this underdog keep pace? To find out, let's take a look at a couple of documents to see how accurately each program interprets the text. All right, so here we go. We have the OpenBook software. It's all ready to go on the computer. The computer's set up, our camera's set up, and I'm just gonna put in our first document, which is our CIL brochure or pamphlet, some information about the CIL. Place it right under the camera right there. And then I'll press the space bar to get the snapshot. And we'll hear what OpenBook does with this first document.
Center 1, the Center for Independent Living. Core services include one-on-one cross-disability peer counseling, information and referral, independent living skills training, transitioning, helping people transition from skilled nursing facilities.
Well, it seemed to handle the brochure with ease. It was unfazed. That's a term I like to use, kind of fun. But now we'll move on to a magazine, of course. Choose something with some text on it. Line it up under the camera. Once again, the space bar. You hear the shutter sound, and then it'll start reading it. There it is. Not exactly what's on the page, but an interesting interpretation of what's going on. Well, now it's starting to pick it up a little bit after probably a paragraph or two. So this is the page that we just took a picture on with the OpenBook software, and it did have some issues. There's a lot going on in terms of color and in terms of visuals, not just text. That could have thrown it off. Also, it's a magazine, so it's highly glossy, and then that may have been reflecting light, so that may have been a problem as well. So very interesting. Now, speaking of glossy pages and non-glossy pages, we'll go to a book, a very well-written book, I may add. Hopefully one day you'll read it. Now, I know that alignment is very important, so you want to align the edge of the book with the edge of the bar down here, the alignment bar. Make sure it's all set up and flat. Press the space bar to take a picture. We hear the shutter sound. Ah, it's music to my ears. And we'll see what it does with this page.
And always have the option of refusing a job they do not want. The arrangement is clearly reciprocal, whether as an exchange of funds or services, and Peter is able to use the system with no residual guilt or obligation. This is not true.
Everything looks and sounds just about right. So the OpenBook software is fairly impressive. It's very easy to read and easy to operate. Once we did a little bit of trial and error with the placement of the page underneath the document reader, everything was just fine. Our pamphlet read almost perfectly. We had a little bit of trouble, some bumps in the road with our magazine. We were figuring out if maybe it was just because there's more than text on the page, there's more color, there's more images, and also it's high gloss. That may have thrown off the camera just a little bit. But then when we got to our book, which is nothing but text, It's not a glossy page. We had a pretty good job at having the document take the picture and have read back to us. Still a little bit of trial and error with the page placement, so once you get that down, it should work most of the time for you. Now I think we should check out our Prizmo iPhone app and see what that does.
No visible page. Up, 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 left, left, right. Page detected.
All right, it's now time to check out our Prizmo iPhone app to see what it can do. It's already loaded onto the phone now. We're going to do the same three documents that we did when we were checking out the OpenBook software. We'll start with our CIL pamphlet. Now, if you have a screen reader, it's going to help you line it up, and I'm going to keep it flat on the page and see if that helps. I was holding it up, and that may have changed how the reader reads it. I'll press done after the picture is set. I will then click on the picture. And then I will say, read text aloud. Preparing text.
IF plus plus. Independent living core services include one-on-one cross. Independent living skills train. Disability peer counseling. Information.
So we tried with our CIL pamphlet. The beginning was very choppy, and then it kind of got into the flow of things and started to read it fairly accurately after that. All right, let's move on to our magazine as we did with the OpenBook software. Have it to the same page that we tried before, lining it up, taking a picture with the Prizmo app, done. Have it loaded in, and I'm gonna press export text. Perform OCR, absolutely. Blue bar scans the page. And now we press read text aloud.
Really fun. Everyone gets a kick out of it, and everyone walks away with some enlightenment
at the same time. Appreciation for the game. Michael O'Leary began playing pickleball.
It sounds and looks exactly as it does on the page. That is straight on. All right, lining up the book right now. Go through the same process. Everything's lined up. It's in the phone. And let's see what happens with this. This is the same page. Export text. A few more steps than the OpenBook software, but not by much. Still very easy to use. It's scanning a lot of text, so it's taking a little longer to scan. Making sure it gets every last letter. And now we want to read text aloud.
Oh. Have predictable and fairly permanent living units he first moved into an accessible key.
It started out right on, and then it started to fall apart a little bit for some reason. So it could be a lighting issue. It could be the, it could be how far the phone is from the page. There are a lot of different factors, or the fact that it's just very text heavy. So just like with the OpenBook software, there is a lot of trial and error. It's all trying it out and seeing what works and what doesn't work and what works best for you. But hopefully you were able to glean something out of our little head-to-head competition. I know I learned something. So OpenBook is a much more refined product, and for $1,600 you would hope so. Its text conversion is more accurate and robust. Because of the speed with which it can take pictures, OpenBook is a great resource for transcribing books, magazines, and especially textbooks if you're a student. Luckily for students with limited vision, the exorbitant $1,600 price tag is fairly easily covered by the Department of Rehabilitation here in California. Prizmo, on the other hand, is a quick and easy way to dictate the characters of a short note or business card, with the file going straight onto your iPhone. While it may not achieve the same ease of use that OpenBook can claim, its functionality for a $10 iPhone app is impressive, to say the least. Either way, if you're someone who is blind or has limited vision, OCR devices should be an invaluable asset. For the CIL, I'm Raphael Siegel. We'll see you next time on Power On.